You're tying my hands. Now, I thought that the whole point at the beginning was to bring out all the evidence that wasn't...
The Queen and Travers! The Queen and Travers!
What's this? Hey. Just don't be frightened. You tell the truth, everything will be all right.
If they believe me.
Well, they will. Hey, give us a smile, huh?
I think that's it. I don't think I've forgotten anything.
It certainly doesn't look like it. You've got enough stuff there to equip an army. Queensland's the Sunshine State, you know. It's another world up there.
Well, I know I'm going to love it. It'll be wonderful to get away from here.
Well, if you're quite sure that you haven't left the gas on or the back door unlocked, we're just about ready to go.
No, everything's done. I've been round and checked to make sure. I've cancelled the paper and the milk. I don't think there's anything else.
Well, let's get started before you think of something.
A verdict is expected today in the case
just
of
a minute, Charles.
Travers,
I want to listen
who is
to
appealing
that.
Against a life sentence handed down in September of last year. Travers was convicted for the murder of her husband. And now for the sporting details. Football fans today are excited about the possibility of a fine win.
Why the sudden interest? Did you know her?
Yes, slightly. Long time ago.
I remember the original case. I always thought it was such a tragedy. A beautiful young girl like that. With the whole of her life ahead of her. And, of course, I only knew what I read in the papers at the time. But it always seemed to me there was much more to it than met the eye. I suppose the reason I felt sympathetic was... because she was just about the age of my own daughter. Well, I wish her luck.
Lyra does have a point, you know. I'd hate anything to go wrong.
I'm sure we can trust Lynn.
Those are my feelings too. Otherwise, I wouldn't have agreed. The press are particularly sensitive about outside work schemes at the moment.
Oh, that's only because of one or two isolated incidents.
That isolated incident is what sells newspapers.
Oh. Don't they realise? I mean, it's far better to have a rehabilitated person taking a useful place in society rather than a prisoner who can only be a drain.
You don't have to convince me. You're talking to the converted. Some of the board already think that my ideas are far too liberal.
I'd like to extend the scheme to include other girls.
Yes, well, I don't want to rush into things. Let's see how Lynn gets on first.
She'll be fine, absolutely no worries at all. I'll stake my job on her.
You already have. Mine too, possibly.
Hi, Mr. Butterfield. It's a lovely day, isn't it?
You reckon?
Mm-hmm.
Well, at least you're on time for your first day.
Oh, it's a good buzz. Bit of a hike up the lane, though.
Well, I must say, I wasn't expecting you to turn up all by yourself.
Oh, it'd be too embarrassing in a paddy wagon.
Yeah. Well, look, I better get you started. Let's see, you can put your stuff around here, see?
Mm-hmm.
And the toilet's around the back, okay?
Okay.
Now, you know about seedlings, don't you?
Oh, yeah, I used to do some transplanting with Dad, and we had this garden at the prison that,
Oh, good. Well, let's see what you can do with this lot. Now, I'll tell you what I want you to do. Mm-hmm. Take the seedlings out of the box and pot them in these, right?
Okay.
And then after that, label them all. Mm. Now, you'll find some gloves over there if you want to use them.
No, I'll be okay, thanks.
Oh, and put today's date on them, will you?
Yep.
Now, I've got to go out for a while,
mm-hmm.
but Mrs. Grant will be coming in soon.
Yes.
She's usually only half an hour late. Any questions you can ask her.
Okay.
You'll be all right on your own?
Oh, yes, I've got plenty to do.
Okay.
See you, Mr. Butterfield. Come on, dogs. You coming inside?
Excuse me, madam. Would you be kind enough to come back to the shop with me and bring your handbag with you?
Then.
Hi. Time for a break? I'm off to lunch. Want to keep me company?
Thanks, Jean. I'm a bit busy at the moment.
Oh. Well, that's okay. My ego can cope. Any news of Karen's trial?
Nope. Unless it's going better than it did yesterday, it'll be a farce. She won't stand a chance. I'm beginning to think it was all a stupid idea.
Why?
How's she going to take it if the jury goes against her, Jean? You're the expert, you tell me.
It won't be easy for her. But she can't be worse off than what she is now. Look, Steve Wilson is a very successful lawyer. Now, he wouldn't have taken on the case if he didn't think he could win.
Yeah, true.
Sure you don't want to come? We could go Dutch.
Oh, your offer touches me, but...
Well, good to see someone so dedicated to his work.
The order for Gregson's?
Oh, sorry, I don't know anything about it, but I'll get someone who does. Okay. Mrs. Grant! Mrs. Grant! Look, I'm sorry, Mrs. Grant's not here and Mr. Butterfield's gone out somewhere.
No, it's okay, I found him.
Oh, are you sure? I wouldn't like to make a mistake.
Yeah, sure, look, there's the name.
Oh, fine.
Okay, how much do I owe you? It'll be on the invoice.
$39.50.
Here you go.
Oh, you wouldn't have the right money, would you? The office is locked and I haven't got any change.
Look, I'm in a bit of a hurry. Buy yourself a Coke.
Stand on the white line. Shoplifting. On remand till tomorrow.
I'll handle it.
Could be difficult.
Oh, no name. One of those.
The usual refuses to give it. But the police have taken her fingerprints and checking the records.
Turn around. There's nothing to be gained by being uncooperative, you know. You can still be charged and convicted without a name on the warrant. In fact, there's an additional charge of hindering the police. Empty your pockets and put your bag here. One handkerchief. Cigarettes, matches. One purse containing $3.41. Compact. And a comb. That's all. Well, you're certainly traveling light. Give us your watch. We tell you what time it is in here. Sign. I said sign it!